My name is Dennis. I'm 67 years old, and I have a very large bump on the back of my head and three smaller ones on the sides and top. This is the bump on the back of my head, and as you can see, it is very loose. The bump on the top of my head's been there for 30 years. The big bump on the back is probably 6 years old, and the two smaller ones that are on the side of my head have showed up since the back bump. The one on the back of my head, I'll bet it weighs every bit of a pound. This is the style of helmet I used to wear, but to fit correctly, it needs to go down all the way, and with the bump in the back, it's not going any farther than this. I haven't rode for a long time because the equipment doesn't fit correctly, and I should be enjoying things more than I am today. T, thank you, dear. My wife's name is Donna. We were married in 95, so the bump on my head has always been there. So she knew what she was getting into.
I know for over 30 years you've been telling me you're gonna do something about the bumps. I have a whole fear that one could explode. I would be lost without you. I mean, we've been together 32 years. I couldn't imagine life without you. I'm scared of the lumps because I don't know what the lumps could do to him. He's been with me over half my life. He is my life, you know.
I'm here today at Dr. Lee's office. A little bit of anxiety.
Hi, Dennis.
Hi.
Hello, how are you?
Fine, how are you doing?
Good. I'm going to walk you guys over to our consult room to see Dr. Lee.
All right.
My wife, Donna, she's been a real force to get me to have this done. And I don't know if I'd be here if it wasn't for her.
All right, and Dr. Lee will be in shortly.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
I've waited 30 years, so I hope that it ends up being taken care of, and tomorrow I'll be on my way back home. And I'll feel much better afterwards.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Dennis, right? Nice to meet you.
Yeah,
what was your name again?
Donna.
Donna. Nice to meet you, Donna.
A few months ago during quarantine, I was able to meet with Dennis and Donna over at video conference.
I have this other problem.
He's got a fear of doctors. I don't care if he won't tell you that, but he does. We've been together 33 years now. I think he's gone to the doctor maybe two or three times.
Shall we take a look? Okay, first of all, let's see the baby. The baby's on top. Okay, with you, let me take a little feel of this.
Sure.
Okay, I think this is probably a pilar cyst. It just got softened. There's a chance it could be a lipoma, too. And you got another twin right here.
Actually, a triplet.
You are right. There is a triplet there. Then you have this one here. If this is a pilar cyst, that's the most giant pilar cyst I've ever seen.
I'm feeling a little doubtful that this is a pilar cyst. I mean, the last one I saw that was even approaching this size was probably two-thirds of the size of it.
I think we should do that one first, and then these three. I mean, once we get started, I'm gonna go for it.
My worry is, of course, on the scalp, the area bleeds a lot. If this is attached at a wide base, it's going to be really problematic figuring out how to fix this up.
I will go get ready. We'll make sure you're nice and comfortable, as always, okay?
Wave yourself around, because that's your last little bobble.
Oh.
Okay? Okay, I'll see you in a little bit.
I'd totally be lying if I didn't say I didn't have a little anxiety, because it's still an operation.
Comfortable?
Yeah.
Okay, just a little baby pinch here, right kind of where we went. Are you okay?
Yeah.
And you shouldn't feel anything. I'll have plenty of numbing if you need it.
I was able to remove the entire cyst, and I'm really pretty proud of myself that I removed it in one piece without rupturing it, even though this one was pretty big.
No way. Pretty much 2 pounds.
I feel much better now.
So that was a big one. I didn't know what we were getting into.
Well, hopefully the other ones won't be this much trouble.
Well, I think we might need to split this up a little bit.
Oh, no.
So we'll tackle the other three in a couple days.
I know that I said that I'd be able to do these all today, but because there was a lot of oozing, I'm really concerned that he could develop a hematoma there. And oftentimes when you're a little older too, sometimes you're more prone to bleeding more easily. So I really think it's a better idea for me to do this one today and have him come back another day for me to remove the rest.
Hi, Donna.
I still see one left.
Yes, we did this one on its own.
Wow. I got back there and I could still see lumps. And I didn't know what to think, but one of my biggest prayers was to have the big one gone. Oh, aren't you gonna be happy to be done today?
Oh, I'm so excited.
I'm a little anxious, but I hope today's procedure goes as smooth as the other one and I can get the other three bumps off my head. Good morning.
You made it back.
I did.
More.
Dennis was here just the other day, and I removed this giant pilar cyst on his head. I was really concerned about the bleeding and how he would really heal. But I do see that he has tolerated fairly well, so I think I can try to remove those other bumps today. All righty. Now these can get wet.
Well, you think they're gonna pop?
It's when I start talking about it that I get into trouble, so I'm trying to give it respect. It was a lot of work to remove four cysts off Dennis in 2 days, but I don't think that he hates me, and I'm pretty happy with the job we did. You want to see something nice, though?
Oh, my God.
No bump.
Where are they? Dr. Lee changed my life because I don't have to live with these bumps anymore. I had total confidence in Dr. Lee. It's an amazing sight just to see my head without the bumps, and she did a fantastic job.
Oh, my God.
There you go.
Wow.
There's your handiwork.
Oh, my husband looks like a brand new man. I'm so happy. When we go places anymore, everything can just be like normal. We don't have to worry about who's looking, who's doing what, who's going to say something. Thank God for Dr. Lee. They're gone.
You're a whole new person.